What's going on, everyone? It is Joe the Lawnmower, and today's video has been 16 years in the making. Let's get started. So like I was saying, this video is 16 years in the making because of this piece of equipment right here. This is an Echo string trimmer. It's an SRM 261. It was actually made in 2006. If you guys aren't familiar with my channel, my father actually had a lawn business when I was growing up. I pretty much worked with him from the age of 13 until I graduated college. He had a lawn business on the side. He worked two jobs to support our family growing up, and he worked his ass off all those years, and he's retired now. So this is one of the pieces of equipment that I got to keep from him. I use it pretty much every week in my lawn. This thing just runs so great to this day. So this string trimmer right here gets a spring tune up every year, even since when he had his lawn business. This thing was obviously getting used a lot. My dad had upwards of 60 lawns a week, and obviously this thing got used 6 months out of the year during the lawn cutting season. Like I said, spring tune-up consisted of a fuel filter change, it consisted of an air filter change, a spark plug change, things like that, new heads, new shields if they needed them, and this thing still runs really great to this day. So obviously these are two-stroke engines, so they do get mixed with oil. This is a 51 ratio. So what I use is just a pre-mix 51 ratio fuel that you can find at the stores nowadays. I usually don't go to the gas station now and mix up the oil myself. I used to, but it's just easy enough. I'm not doing a ton of yard work. I'm just using it at my house. So what I do is I just go to the store, get that 51 mix. It's good to go. I put it both in my weed or my string trimmer right here, and I also put it in my backpack blower as well. I actually reached out to Echo to see if they actually could send me a hat. I told them I had an idea for a video about showcasing an Echo trimmer, just showing them how long these Echo trimmers can actually last. And if you take care of them, you don't abuse them, you do the maintenance that you're supposed to. So they were kind enough to send out this hat that I'm wearing here today to shoot this video for you guys and show you guys this Echo trimmer right here. So I'm gonna start her up so you guys can hear what it sounds like 16 years later. I would say it sounds pretty good for 16 years later to me. As you can see, pretty much a lot of my front yard is a lot of edging. I use a string trimmer to edge. I don't use a traditional edger or a stick edger. I've cut many lawns in my day. We've always used string trimmers, as you can see. It's a very controversial subject, actually, edging with a string trimmer. I don't know why, but as you can see, my edge looks really great. If you're interested in seeing a full-length video that I did on explaining how I cut or how I string trim a lawn or use a weed eater on a lawn, go check out the video below. I did this last year. It's a full in-depth video. Go check it out. It'll explain everything on why I do it this way and why maybe you should look into doing it that way as well. So before I end today's video, I just want to show you how easy it really is to string these string trimmers up. I always see people, you know, they have the automatic ones that are out there now where they have like a little button there and it does it for you, or you have that crank one where you feed the string through and it cranks it in there for you. These heads have been around for a very long time. You know, Echo obviously makes these and you can find their parts online and things like that. If these heads, these bottoms, once you tap them enough times, you know, they'll tend to wear out. You just get a new one. You don't gotta get a whole new head. You could just get these spools, and all you gotta do is take out the old one, put in a new one, and you're good to go. But this is actually how I string my trimmers up. All you have to do is turn the head right here and pull it out. I'm not gonna put a full length cord on here. I'm just gonna use what I have so I can show you. It's really not that hard. Obviously, if I was starting over again, I would want to cut the cord to a certain length. It really doesn't matter. I usually do a couple full arm lengths long. So once you cut your cord and you feed the line through, obviously you wanna fold it through one of the ends right there. It's one of those little loops. These can go bad over time. All you gotta do is get a new spool and you're good to go. So once you do feed that cord through, I usually always put the two tips together and then I just string it through so it's nice and tug. Always hold my in my left hand. Obviously you want to make sure that you are reeling it up the certain way. There's the arrow right there on there. Hold it in my left hand. Then what I do is I like to put my index finger in between the two cords just so that way it kind of goes in there evenly. And then from there, I'm just feeding it through and I'm just rotating my left hand a little bit at a time. I got my index finger between the cord and you're gonna do that all the way up. Once you get up to, I would say, a couple inches long, what you wanna do is clip on the one end there and then clip on the other end here. And then from there, you can throw it on the actual head of the string trimmer. So once you have your spool all lined up and it's nice and tight, there's actually these little grooves in here that you're gonna line up with these nipples here. To make life a lot easier, what I like to do is actually turn these nipples right here to match the different holes right here. So that way when you put your spool on, it's easy just to tighten it up. So all you gotta do is feed it back on. I usually just do this on the ground. So up here, it's a little bit harder for me. Plus, I'm trying to show you guys. So as you can see, it's nice and aligned. All you're gonna do is push that head on, and then from there, you just tighten it up. And then if this is just a little bit longer, all you gotta do is clip this with a needle nose, scissors, whatever you got, and you're good to go. It's really not that difficult to string these up. I know there's that automatic wind that a lot of those newer string trimmers have, but honestly, after doing this a couple times, obviously I've done it for a long time, for many years, but once you do it a few times, you're gonna get used to it. It's really not that hard. As long as you're not putting a ton of cord in here at once and you're not, like, you know, jam packing that cord in there, you should be fine. It shouldn't get stuck. You should just wind it up, throw it on, and you're good to go. That's pretty much it for today's video, guys. As you can see, if you take care of your equipment just like this Echo string trimmer has, it can last you a really long time. 16 years later, this thing sounds really great still to this day. If you enjoyed today's video or if you found today's video helpful, make sure you smash that like button. That really actually does help out with the channel. If you have any questions or concerns on today's video, leave it down in the comments section below. And if you're interested in any of my other content, I'm available on Instagram. I'm available on TikTok. Go check me out there. And like always, guys, I'll see you in the next one.